Nice. Steam is, I haven't set steam up properly yet for the for TPTS. It'll need to be another EMU. Yeah, let's try this one and see whether it works. This one did work previously. Let me fire up the mod. This one's the Glasgow Airport Rail Link one. Jono is not the most exciting route. I haven't started the bot yet, don't get excited. And when I do start the bot, please don't troll. I need to test it and make sure it works and fix it if it doesn't. Right, yes, projects. Right, so let me just go in here and lock the camera. So reverso 100 works, throttle minus 100, that works, and throttle 100, that works. The brakes have come off, wipers, I'll just turn the wipers on. Can you stop? This is a another test we need to know. You can stop as well. Bonus. We're doing better than yesterday. Do the doors work? Doors work. Headlights. Headlights work. I think wipers command doesn't actually work. Tasks works. Right, I think we've got enough to make this one work. Right, let me come out and I'll restart the TSL bot. Restart that. Fire that back up. Put the instructions on and update them as needed. So throttle is minus 100 to 100, reverse, so there is no brake. Everything else is as it was. Put you in the cab, put the wipers on, TSL bot, TPTS on. All yours, folks. I'm going to leave you to it, and I will be back shortly. Brandon Redboy, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Well done. Well, Joel, good job. Well, that worked really well. wait, Mead, earlier on I did notice you were saying that someone must be here because the task list appeared. You typed exclamation mark tasks to bring that up. Yeah, good job, everybody. Well done. I did see, I had it on the telly in the living room while I was watching. Good job. DemonLord007, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Let me just see if I missed any others while I was out. You're better drivers. Okay. PZB scenario next, then. And Jack Simpoe, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated as well. Looks like another one that I missed while I was I were busy. Right, I'm going to turn the camera and the microphone off while I get, because I've got dessert. No one needs to see me eating dessert. So we're going to get the next scenario going. In order to do that, I need to get the rail driver connected. We are going with a 57 Freightliner. You only drive British and North American trains. That was a really good job, guys. That was a really good job. What I saw about it, I saw probably about the sort of like a bit in the middle. Well, I left the camera on. You could see I wasn't here. Okay. Where are we now? Flats to Felixstowe. Let's switch to changing route. Oh, and turn the bot off. Yeah, absolutely. Bot is gone. Toast. History. Camera wasn't on. The camera was on, but it was showing on the green screen. So all you saw was the fake studio background image. But the camera was definitely on. If I'd have been here, you would have seen it. Right, let me get this. This is by A. Rubin, who's on the chat. Now, I don't know whether or not the rail driver is set up to work with this. If it isn't, we'll just import and use the keyboard. This one is... That's to Felixstowe. It's by A. Rubin, 1971. GEML Class 57 Freightliner. Because we haven't done much of the 57 either, I noticed. Amtrak Master, I don't know. Send me a whisper message with a link to it and I'll take a look, but I've got a reasonable plan for this evening now. We'll be doing American trains a bit later on. I think I've got 3 in the list to do at the moment, yeah. Good afternoon, driver. Today you are hauling this load of empty wagons to Felixstowe Harbour. Traffic is light, you shouldn't encounter any delays. You can depart when ready. Make sure your path is set. That one. Going via Westerfield P1. Where is Westerfield P1? That'd be up there somewhere. There is a train already there. It's wholly unpleasant of it. Going the wrong way. Switch that. Oh no, that'll bring us up around that way.
Okay.
So when it says we shouldn't encounter any obstructions, the rest doesn't work. At all. Oh, of course it's one of those. Is that because of rail driver? Okay, I don't understand why that beeping is going off.
There!
A I'm trying to get the pedal out. It sounds like DSD, but I've got... That's all done. Got a general alarm going off. What? Oh, is it starting cold? Engine stop light isn't on, so we're running. Put the key in first, yeah. Got the E key. Whatever it is, it's stopping us moving. Instrument light dimmer switch. Oh, I should remove the commands here, that's a good shout. Turn the engine off and back on. Well, this has got a heck of a startup sequence, so I'm reluctant to do that. Variable speed wiper control. Yeah, let's restart. I don't know what's causing that alarm to come up. Put the key in first. Basically the 57 uses the body shell of a 47, but everything inside it is different. Right, put that on. That's better. We do need to set the path up, which we set up before and haven't done this time. I raised the pantograph. Chris. I can see our engine signal here is a red, so I'm just coasting up to it. Thanks, Amtrak Master. If I get a chance, we'll have a look at it today. I don't know if you notice, you can move the newspaper. If I get a chance, we'll have a look at the scenario, but we'll see what the time is. I've got plenty of scenarios to look through for today. And basically, what we can do is we're going to run train sim up till about 11 o'clock, and then we're going to do a bit of trucks. I was going to ask you all, actually, what your preference is towards Euro Truck and American Truck. Fridays we normally do American Truck Sim. Is that cool with everybody? Yes, I remember you, Alexandra Nicolay. That's some cracking AI so far. Well, it just got started. Green light. Trackside simulation says, why is it fair for newer scenarios to be played before scenarios have been on the list for months? Because it's not a question of fair. I play the scenarios that I want to look at and I want to show. And if there's something comes up that I want to show more, And sometimes it's, I want to show this. This looks like a good scenario, so I'm not going to show another one that's identical or very similar to it. So that one, one of them will wait, and I'll do the other one. And sometimes it's just, it's a luck of the draw almost. It's nothing for or against anybody in particular. It's just when I put the show together, I look through all of the scenarios that have been suggested, and I try and take as many from that list as possible. But the other thing I found is that the list of suggested scenarios is the suggested scenarios people have made. So this is, please play my scenario. That's not necessarily the please play the best scenarios that are on workshop. And what I want to do is play the best scenarios that are on workshop, as well as showcasing what people are doing as well. And the other, so what I found was that by just playing the stuff that was suggested, I was actually missing some really cool stuff that was up on workshop. So I started mixing it about a little bit. So it's it isn't a question of fair or not fair. It's by all means, do what other people do and jump up and down and say, "Hey, play my scenario. It's good because," and make it good. You know, make it. Tell me why it's a good scenario, because there's a lot of scenarios out there which are, people keep suggesting me 60-minute scenarios with, and they turn out to have no AI trains, and that's it. I love that newspaper, the way it just falls. So what are we doing anyway? Oh, we're just going into Felixstowe. Ipswich to Felixstowe. All mine are epic, full stop by me. Let's get a screenshot. Got a green light. Big HUD on, don't need big HUD on. Trackside, yes, the newspaper slides around based on the gravity, so I'm on super elevation at the moment. I think that's what's causing it. So if I also need to go to here, settings. Cab background on. Oh, this thing slips at the drop of a hat. I must admit, sometimes, I'm going to be completely honest, I get a little bit lazy when I'm picking scenarios, and there are some authors that I know are going to get me a scenario that works and is interesting to look at. I tend to, if I'm running short on time, I will tend to default to them, which isn't right, but... Very graduated. Yeah, I'm only moving the lever up the smallest amount that I can move it up, and it still manages to split the wheels a bit. What's this thing look like on the outside, Peachlick? 47. Where are we heading to? We're going to Felixstowe, just round the corner essentially. So we started here just north of Ipswich. We're running all the way down and we're going to go down to Felixstowe docks here. Shed coming out the other way. Yeah, it's predominantly Freightliner up and EWS in these parts. And I think the container ops are quite often Freightliner now. Does the screen, well, the data cord? No, I don't think it does. Doesn't do it. Oh, I have got a custom script set up for this already. That's why it's working. Excellent. Quarter limit over the crossover. Limit. This is where we take. This is the branch now that takes us down to Felixstowe. See the newspaper moving all on its own. It's not me. One thing you have to remember is that there are, as in reality, there's a delay, so you'll notch, and then a few seconds later the engine will actually respond. Wipe me, to be fair, I might get so many scenarios I can't play them all. Yeah, I can't remember what the list is at the moment, but it's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. Hey, we've been so far so good, mate, and it's good to be driving the 57, because as I said earlier, we don't really do anything with the 57. Do I have Farming Sim Gold or Standard? I've got the Gold Edition now, Trekmaster. It was cheap during the summer sale, so I thought, well, seems rude not to. Do we have hot plate abuse? I believe in one of the recent GEML updates, one of the bridges that had a wall over it has gone. It's been fixed. Do farmers go to harvester for lunch? I think they do, and what they also like to do is go in groups and combine their checks. Yeah, GEML received an update a while ago now, quite a long time ago actually, a few months ago. Trackside simulations, no, this one was made by Ubi. The newspaper's a neat touch, isn't it? Sitting there rolling backwards and forwards. coming up on Derby Road. He's up on the power. Ploughman's all round. Yeah, indeed, Sergeant K, indeed. Tomorrow we're doing, tomorrow will be just a stream with, so Cameron, is my son, is going to do a takeover of the channel, and he's going to be running some train sim stuff. He did that a while ago and everyone said, when can he come back? So he wants, I've spoken to him and he wants to come back tomorrow. I probably won't be streaming anymore over the weekend. I'm going to try and have some early nights and get ready for work again on Monday. Work. Got to try and remember what that is. I've been off for a week and 2 days. Arnold Ace Rimmer donated 750. A ribbon scenario is always fun, even the short ones. I'm off to the pub now, might be back in time for ATS. If not, have a great weekend and smoke me a kipper. Thank you very much, Arnold. Can I get some GGs for Arnold? Well done, pretty, really good. Thank you very much, Arnold. What's the horn sound like? Like that. We've got two tones. Oh, that's presumably what we were waiting for, was for that one to come off of a single track. Alexandra Nicola, how old is the son? Cameron is 13. Do the wiper? Oh, because it's dry. Guys, you should never be sharing your ages or anything like that online. I know I did that with Cameron, but generally speaking, don't share any information about yourselves. See you later, Arnold. Thanks very much again. Fourteen trains. To the bank holiday at the end of August. Yeah, we're going to have model railway. That'll be lots of OMR streaming over that bank holiday weekend. It should be good. I should have Friday off as well, Chris, because or if I haven't, I'm going to get it booked off because it's insomnia on that weekend. I'm looking at going on the Friday. There's also the Bristol show coming up, so Bristol Engine Model Engineering Show coming up, and I'm hoping to go there. Again, I need to double check the dates and double check what I've got booked off. 60 limit here. Speed limit. We'll need plenty of sleep for insomnia, yeah. Oh, I just realised all the game's detail settings are turned right down. They're getting 60 FPS. Must remember to turn the settings back up again before the next scenario. Hey Muggy! I've got an ice lolly here just waiting to be consumed after this scenario. See, Rogers, you know, you're sorry for the jokes, you don't know where you're getting from the bottom of a deep, dark pit. We all know the answer to that question. it's like a Calipo, it's a Robinson's Fruit Shoot one. I couldn't find Calipos, so I bought the Fruit Shoot ones instead. So we like a Calipo, but with more sugar, probably. I'm going to turn the camera off and turn the mic on and off as required, so that you don't see me eating, because no one needs to see that. All right, camera will be back shortly. Oh, teleported away. And what was the reason for crashing into the buffers, driver Peddleston? I was eating an ice cream. Left that a bit too long. Quality of the picture's improved now the camera's gone. I kind of want a do-over now, that was really nice and it took no time at all to eat because I left it until it basically melted. Thanks for the host, Cospap. Hey, I'm back. Need a freezer in the garage. Oh yes, the ghostly hand. I do like the sounds on this. It sounds awesome as it winds up. Yeah, look, Francois, I'd let it basically melt, so it was just mush by the time I got to it. So I kind of want to do over. Alexandra Nicolay, every scenario, everything I do goes up on YouTube, unless it goes pathetically wrong. Which means most things go up to YouTube, strangely enough. You wouldn't let it melt. Well, it wasn't my intention to let it melt. My intention was to start, was to eat it at the beginning of the scenario, but I got into the scenario. Fortunately, the game has decided to hide behind windows, so I can't actually see what's going on the HUD at the moment in terms of my ETA. What happened when I first tried to play the scenario A, Ruben? I think it was the reverser was set to forwards, and it caused what sounded like a DSD alarm to go off, but I couldn't get the DSD alarm to reset. I know, Moggy. Bad me. Right, we've got a 15 followed by a 25. We are going by a trimly disused. We're not stopping. Have I abused the hot plate yet? Oh, the hot plate has been having a good kick in. Alexandra Nicolay, it is 8 o'clock. Leaving it way too late to break. Alright, we've got the right indicator. We rerouted via the north yard, check the switches. Let's do that then, shall we? So we're coming in via the north, and we need to go to terminal line 8, which is all the way over on the left hand side. All is good. Hectic T, Super Voyager or Pendolino? Well, I guess it depends whether you want diesel or electric, because if you pick Pendolino and you're in a diesel-only area, you ain't going very far unless it's downhill. But in equivalent circumstances, I love the Pendolino. I think it's lovely. The Voyager's nice too, I don't have anything against it, but of the two. Ugly Duckling? Although I don't agree with that. I like it. I think the 70 is lovely. Moggy, you would just like to let everyone know you bought a book this morning. Excellent. Trucking 151, next route is Trent Valley. Got Felixstowe Freight Terminal down there somewhere. Francois says we have 924 scenarios on official routes, 112 scenarios of workshop routes, and 7 on Nestlé Loft, around 1,043, or just over 1,000 scenarios played. There you go. It's a freight terminal. Have we ever bumped into any mods at shows? Moggy dared to show his face at Brighton. But otherwise than that, no. Not yet, anyway. And Steve, obviously. The 1A and 1D tender, I think it's down to its capacity. Amtrak, you've got to see a 70 over in America on a flatbed on a Norfolk Southern train to be shipped to the UK. Nice! Coming up to the 10 limit. Francois, I am sure I will be back up to Stirling. That's having an office up there. Hikari UK, yeah, the newspaper slides. I can also pick it up and slide it myself. And if you don't like it, if you slide it all the way, it just goes away. Chopping the speed now for 10. Hold the hot plate. Just because. Did I meet anyone in Scotland? No, I didn't, Francois. Monty was hoping to meet up with me, but he wasn't able to either. There we go, BRCW104 DMU says the BR1A tender is 5,000 gallons of water, the BR1D tender is 4,725. There's our stopping point at Terminal 8. Rolling up to the end. Slowing down a bit too much now. Come on. Get to the end of the siding. Favourite food, Alexandra Nicolay? Spaghetti bolognese would be my favourite dinner. Can't get enough spaghetti bolognese. Surface PC, yeah, Surface PC is just still doing really well, actually. And so is my daughter's Windows 10 tablet. I ought to get my... make sure my Surface has been upgraded over before I go back. Otherwise, just in the middle of a really important meeting, it'll probably decide, oh, now's a great time to upgrade to Anniversary Edition and reset all of your settings. I take it Moggy does not like spaghetti bolognese. There you go. Thoroughly enjoyed that. That was a good scenario, eh, Ruben? Right, now I'm talking about lowering graphics. I need to change the settings. Back them all back up to the top. Right, now... let me do a changing route. I'm going to reset the game since we had that Mosul Valley scenario.